Hey everyone. All right, so in a previous video, I rented a Tesla Model 3 for the day, and one of the things I wanted to check out was the Supercharger network. Now, I've been driving EVs since 2014, and both of my cars had a quick charge port. So I wanted to see what the difference was between a level 3 charge with a company like EVgo or ChargePoint and Tesla's Supercharger. So some of the main things I wanted to check out was how fast the car charged, how easy it was to charge, and how crowded the place was. So here's my little journey to my first Supercharge.
Something just popped up on the screen saying that it's preconditioning the battery for supercharging. How freaking cool is that? My Leaf can't even cool its own battery down, and this thing can, precondition the battery so that it's at its optimal temperature range to get a supercharge. That's freaking awesome. Alright, well, my first attempt at using a supercharger was a failure. There was almost all the spots were full, and the ones that weren't full were broken. So it looked like they had three spots that weren't working. People would put the plug over the rim of the charger, I guess to indicate that it's broken. So I saw that some of the plugs weren't plugged into its holder, which I thought maybe people are just lazy, but I guess that's just letting you know that, hey, this thing's broken. I was really surprised at how full they were. I don't know how many spots there were. I would guess like 10 to 15 spots, and they were all taken, except for the broken ones. Hey, here we go. Attempt number two to go to a supercharger. There we go. Cool. What are we getting? So I'm used to something like 50 kilowatts. Nice. There we go. Okay, and now instead of just like going on my phone like I normally do or trying to take a nap, I am going to play some games. Let's try this one. Sorry, I can't really play and hold the phone at the same time, but I'll let you know how it goes. This time, supercharging was successful. I was here 15 minutes and I got 80 miles, which is awesome. So it was pretty cool to go to a supercharger spot because one, there was a ton of spots. I'm used to seeing a max of two. I was in Oregon and there was a station that had four stations and I thought that was a lot. This Tesla station looked like it had 15, which was really cool. And it was really weird just to see only one brand of car, but you know, obviously it's the Tesla network, so that's what you're gonna see. Okay, so like everything with the Model 3, supercharging was nice and easy and a nice experience. The process of charging is more streamlined than what I'm used to. If you have not experienced a supercharger, basically, like the video, all you do is you unplug it from the unit, plug it into your car, and that's it. It will start charging on its own. It will automatically bill your account. You don't have to swipe a card or anything. As opposed to what I'm used to, well, here, this is what I'm used to. Now, it's not a huge difference, but taking out that step of scanning payment is a nice way to streamline the process. Now, the car charged faster than what I'm used to, so here's how much charge I can get in 15 minutes.
and the availability of the superchargers is awesome. The second place I went to that had 24 spots, I would say at least half were still available. So 12 spots open up. That's so cool. You know, I don't get range anxiety. I'm pretty in tune with my car and I know how far I can go with it. But I do sometimes get charging anxiety. Most of the time there are one or two stations only at a whatever place that I go to. And if both of those spots are occupied, there's a good chance that those people are going to be there for 30 or 40 minutes. And that can be a pain in the butt. I've seen that superchargers will also have queues. But I feel like if you have 12 or 24 spots, the rate of people going in and out is probably much greater than, you know, only having two spots. If you've gone from a different EV to a Tesla, how do you feel about that? Do you feel like you don't have to wait for superchargers as much as you did for level 3 chargers? Let me know. I think that's it for my Tesla stuff for now, until I can get my hands on hopefully a Model S P100D. That might be a while. That rental is quite a lot of money, but, you know, I can save up. Let me know if you guys want to see something in particular, EV related. I'm always down for suggestions. Also, I'm going to the LA Auto Show at the end of this month. So if there is something that you want to see, like maybe you're not in LA and you want to see something in particular that the LA Auto Show is going to have, let me know in the comments and I'll try to do that for you. I'm super happy that like 99% of the comments that I've gotten on my videos so far have been positive and constructive. So please keep it up. I love interacting with you guys. So thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.